Hey y'all, Crystal and MrsHappyHomemaker.com here, and I have a story to tell. Woohoo, story time, right? So, the year is 1973. My mother is 13 years old, and she is wearing her mother's class ring on her little pinky finger, and she's outside playing football. Well, she loses the ring, and she got in a lot of trouble with her mother. They looked and looked, couldn't find the ring. Gone. Let's fast forward to the 80s, around 1985 or 86. So at that time period, my grandmother, her mother, has been passed away, and I used to go over to what used to be her house that my grandpa still lived in, and I used to play in a big old climbing tree in between their house and the next door neighbor's house. Well, the next door neighbor, she had a grandson named Tony Joyce, and me and him used to play together on this big tree. Well, one day, which I wasn't there for this day, one day he was digging him a hole underneath that tree and found some stuff, and he got in some trouble with his grandpa for digging a big old hole. Well, many years later, that day, they took the things that he had found, put it up into an attic, and it's been long since forgot about. Well, let's fast forward to a few days ago. A few days ago, I heard from Tony, and I sent him a message first, and I said, "Happy birthday." I saw it on Facebook, and he responded, and he said, "You will never believe what just happened. Give me a call real quick. I got to tell you something." So called him up, and they were going, I think his mother was going through the box in the attic, and guess what they found? That's right. They found that class ring that's been missing since 1973. Now, what I should have done is just gone and gotten that ring and not said nothing to my mama and surprised her with it. But, y'all, I got a big old mouth. So, as soon as I found out that they had found this ring, I was on the phone to my mama saying, "Guess what, mama?" Well, she didn't think that the ring was going to make it back to her so soon. They weren't able to ship the ring right now because of some health issues going on. And I was kind of scared to have it shipped because, my luck, the post office would lose it or something. So I made the 4.5-hour each way trip back home to North Carolina, and I retrieved the ring. I did that early this week on Monday. I got back on Tuesday, and I showed up at Wednesday night meals at church, which my mama cooks Wednesday night meals every week. And I showed up and had it on my little pinky finger, or actually I had it on my ring finger, and was bringing her some Nisi sausage from North Carolina. Well, the only place to get Nisi sausage is North Carolina, so that was kind of the telltale sign of where I had been. So she opens up her sausage, and then she hadn't noticed the ring yet, so I did like this. Here's her reaction. So this is my mom's ring. It's my grandmother's ring, her mother's ring from 1942. It's been lost since the 70s. I'm about to go return it to my mama. At church. She cooks Wednesday night meals, so ready to go into the church.
Mwah.
Yes. Woo!
Hot.
One hot.
Where'd you bean come from?
Huh?
Where'd you come from?
I drove North Carolina yesterday and I got it.
That's where you've been.
That's
where you've been.
I don't know how well I do.
I was playing football out back, and I had mama's class ring on my little finger, and I lost it.
In the 70s.